What's up, champs and champettes? It's your boy P-Bet. And we are back with a new series that I'm going to start. It's not on the schedule. It's not a main or side series. It's just one of those any day I want to upload it, I can. And this series is called This Is The Run. And basically what this series is I play permadeath kind of games. You know, games like The Binding of Isaac, FTL, Spelunky, you know, games like that where, you know, when you die, you're dead for good and you have to start all the way back from the beginning of the game. You know, you lose all your progress, you lose all the items you collected, whatever it may be. You go from beginning to end with one life and that is it. And basically, I'm going to be uploading these full runs, whether it may be 5 minutes until I die or, you know, 2 hours until I die, you know. I will be uploading the full uncut run for you guys to enjoy. And it will all be in one video. And basically, the game I have today is called Risk of Rain. This game is an open alpha right now, and it's kind of a mixture between, I'd say, like, Binding of Isaac and, like, with, like, a MOBA twist to it, where you have, like, four abilities, and you kind of use those to make your progression, you collect items on the way, you get gold for killing enemies, stuff like that, and it's a lot of fun, so we're gonna play that today. You can start with two characters in the open alpha. You can either choose the commando, which is a range dude, obviously, you know, based around kiting your enemies around and trying to take them out from a distance. And then you have the miner, who is a melee dude, and he's a lot of fun. I don't know who necessarily I want to pick. I've been having fun with both. I think I'm going to go... You know what? I'm not going to go Miner. I am going to go Commando. Because I've been playing with a Miner a lot. I want to give the Commando a better go here. So, let's play Commando. So, basically, I have my abilities mapped to QWER. They're usually on ZXCV. And I am about to get into a fight. So, they're usually on CWE, but obviously since I play a lot of League of Legends, I mapped it to QWER just because that's what I'm used to. If you play League, I would suggest remapping and making it a little bit more what you're used to. It helped me a lot, so I think you guys should give that a shot. So basically my Q is just pretty much your basic attack. You fire a single shot, it knocks smaller enemies back, and, you know, it's a single target, you know, you do damage to a single target. Your W, and I'm gonna call it QWER, even though it's different in, by default, I'm gonna call it QWER, I'm sure you guys know what I'm talking about. My W, is Full Metal Jacket. Basically, it hits every enemy within your line of sight. It goes a bullet straight through all of them and does damage to all of them, and it knocks back even bigger enemies. So, like, this guy gets knocked back if I use it. I'm gonna actually just jump over here. But yeah, it knocks back longer enemies, and it hits every enemy within the line that you're shooting at. My E, it gives you a little dive, you know, it's good for dodging attacks, getting to, it's good for repositioning. For example, I'll show you up here, actually, if I make my way over here. And the cool thing I like about this game, actually, no, I'll explain that later, I'll keep going with the abilities. My E, obviously, as you see, is like a little tumble, and it's good for repositioning. If these guys are over here, you know, I'm fighting them and I want to get to the other side of them because they're cornering me, I just use my little tumble and I dodge both their attacks, and I give myself a good reposition. And then my R, which is just basically, you unleash a bunch of shots at your enemies. If there's enemies on both sides, your character will shoot, like, in both directions. If there's enemies only on one side, your character will only shoot your barrage of bullets only in that one direction. But as you see, since I have enemies on both sides of me, I have, you know, he's focusing it on one direction. And you see he's shooting him on the left right now, even though it looks like there's no enemies, but there is an enemy on the platform down across from where I was. That's why he's shooting in that direction as well, I assume at least. That's not the, I have no idea, but I mean, I would assume so, you know what I mean? So basically, the premise of the game is to make your way through the levels, which, by the way, I should be doing. I'm dilly-dallying a little bit too long. And you gotta find the teleporter in each level, and then you have to activate the teleporter. When you activate the teleporter, the clock will start ticking. You know, you have to wait 90 seconds as the teleporter boots up. And when you do that, holy shit, these guys are throwing me off. As you do that, enemies start spawning and a boss mob will spawn, and basically you have to just wait until the teleporter activates, and you have to fight your way while the teleporter is activating, Well, and then while the teleport is activating, a lot more mobs spawn and a boss mob spawns. And then when the teleporter finishes activating, you just gotta clear out the enemies that are left, and then you can move on to the next level. It has a really cool MOBA feel to it. That's why I really like this game. Because as you see, every time I kill an enemy, I'm getting experience, gold, I'm leveling up. And it's just a really cool feel. Obviously, when you level up, you do more damage with your attacks. You get more maximum health. But the cool thing about this is you can't really dilly-dally for too long. Like, you have to balance exploring and rushing to find that teleporter and get to the next level. Because as time goes on, as you see on the top right, as time gets on, the difficulty gets a lot harder. So obviously the first 5 minutes are very easy, and then when it hits like the 4 or 5 minute mark, the difficulty goes to easy, and then medium, and then, you know, hard, and then it gets harder and harder each little bit that passes by. And that's why I like it, because you have to kind of balance out your exploring as well as getting to the end, because you can't just explore and, you know, find all the little chests scattered out throughout the level. And I'm sorry if I have the sniffles. I don't know why. They just came out of nowhere when I started recording. Scumbag body just doesn't want to fucking cooperate. That's not my fault. Trust me. I'm not doing this on purpose, obviously. But yeah, it's a lot of fun. As you see, I'm collecting gold. And throughout the level, there's like these little shop vendors and shop stands where you can buy certain items that give you like passive effects. Or you can buy active items, which is like kind of like another spell, which will just give you another effect. I'm gonna open this up. This is one of the passive items. If you play League of Legends, the best way to describe it is Thornmail. But as you're close to your enemies, as they're touching this little particle, they'll get damaged. So, you know, if there's a clump of enemies around you, obviously that's useful for that, because then they're taking damage as they get near you. And I really like it. It's one of those items I typically like to get really early on. And there's also an item I'm going to try and get in this run called Infection. I'm not sure if it's called Infection, but basically what it is it puts a little infection around you, and as you come in contact with an enemy, the infection goes on them. And then they get like a damage over time until they touch you and give you the infection back, or they touch another enemy and give a different enemy the infection. The infection doesn't damage you, albeit, but 14 seconds hitting enemies causes them to drop gold. That's really cool. I might do that, seeing as how there's a big clump of enemies here. Anyway, what is this? Golden gun. More gold, more damage. Oh, that's pretty cool. So the more gold you have, the more damage you do. Alright, I'm gonna use my item here and start getting gold. Give me your gold, scumbags! Huh. Oh, I guess there's a cap. Oh no, there's no cap. It's counting down. I see. Nah, give it, give me your gold! Okay, it ran out. That's a damn shame. Anyways, we're fine. I'm getting cornered here, and there's a lot of enemies. I'm gonna have to clear myself out, because obviously we reached this end of the level, and the teleporter's not here. The teleporter is not here. That is a damn shame, if I do say so myself. But we will get out of this situation. Leave you me. No! I hate these wisps. They stop and they do a little ranged attack, and it becomes a pain in the ass, really. It becomes a huge pain in the ass. Okay. I can't deal with this. I don't have much health. I need to just make a run for it. Oh! I didn't notice that was a wall. I thought it was just kind of a backdrop thing. Okay. Run, P. Run. You have to get up there, and then you have to tumble past the enemies. Tumble, P. Get away. I'm gonna use my gold thing. Ka-ching! Let's do this thing. Farm myself some gold. And I can also take them out, since some enemies can't clear gaps. It's very useful. Obviously, these jellyfish just fly around, so that's interesting. But okay, the jellyfish are actually pretty easy to deal with. They have very low health and very low damage, but they have very good mobility, which makes up for it. They can get through walls pretty easily and stuff like that. So obviously, that's what you have to worry about. So as you see, like, that little meter around my guy is raising. That's because I'm getting more gold. This is actually the first time I've gotten this item, and I just figured out what that was. But the more gold you get, the higher that meter goes, and obviously the more damage you start doing. I really need to get a move on because this is gonna start getting tough. If you don't get to the second level by the time it hits medium, you're gonna have a pretty damn tough time. Unless you made that, unless you made your dilly-dallying worth it and you got like a bunch of good items. I'm stuck. Let's go! Okay, this guy can clearly clear gaps. I didn't even know they could. And they have a really long range too. Alright, he can't get any further. We're good. Gotcha! Skamagadoo! Oh! Okay, I think I know where the teleporter is. Oh my! That was a good amount of fall damage that I really didn't need to take, but I was reckless, and that's just what happens. Okay. We're gonna go down to the right side of the level. I think I know where it is. It's in a little crevice on the right side of the level. The teleporter location changes from time to time. So obviously it's not the same. It's not the same thing every time. And I don't know how many levels are in this. Eesh, I'm taking so much fall damage because I think I can make these jumps, but clearly I can't. Yeah, I don't know exactly how much. Oh, there's a shop down here. Any of these items that I know. I'm going to jump down in this little thing. I like this item. It's a passive that gives you gold over time, and I did not pick it up. I need to go pick that up. And pick up a doo. And basically you're just getting gold over time, and you can get more than one of these items. Like if I find that item again and I get it, it'll just basically be times two, and basically it'll just like make the effect better. So for example, if you gain 10% gold over time, or 10 gold every 10 seconds or whatever, those aren't the numbers obviously, I'm just spitballing here. If that's how much you gain, I assume if you get another one it'd be 20. I'm not sure if it goes from like a 1-to-1 ratio or if it goes like 50% more for each one you have. I'm gonna let these guys actually stay here. I'm gonna use this thing so I can get some farm some gold off these dudes. I'm getting a good amount of gold here. And we're good. Boom! And that is how we do it. And that is how we clean up house, ladies and gentlemen. That is how we clean up house. Alright, we have to go. Difficulty's medium already. This is not good. This is going to be very bad. Summon imps holding rewards. I'm going to do this. I don't think so, scumbags! Get back here! The imps are really cool. They're hard to catch as a miner sometimes, but as commando, it shouldn't be too much of a big deal. Should be able to catch them pretty easily. Alright, we found the teleporter. We're going to go ahead and activate this boss. Hopefully, we can survive this and make it to the next level in the first episode of this series. That'd be nice. I'm wondering what boss we're going to get. And it is the giant stone golem. I actually prefer fighting against him rather than the, I forget what it's called. But it's this, it's pretty much like a squid, but it's massive. And it shoots like these orbs at you. And holy shit, these are enemies. Okay, we're going to go ahead and activate that and try and, get some damage going here. And as you see, we activate the teleporter. Holy fucking damage! Okay, just run, Pete, just run. Get it to the other side of the stone golem and then start popping off when they all get up here. And boom! Okay, we need to get down. 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 We're gonna go ahead and activate the imps again. Boom, boom! Oh, here's the infection. Here's the infection. Toxic centipede. It, as you see, it spreads that infection. Boom, 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 boom. Oh, there's too many enemies on the screen. It's gonna start lagging. And it's not really, like too much in-game lag. And as I said, it's because it's an alpha. The game isn't really optimized to its fullest. So that's why that is. You know, the more enemies on the screen, the more it's gonna kind of slow down a little bit. But I'm gonna see if I can wait until my health regenerates. Or maybe I could use this slow motion to my advantage and make a little bit more, a few more tactical moves here. The only problem I see with that is the fact that if I jump up there and they all attack me at once, I will die. So I'm taking a huge risk here. What I think I'm gonna do, actually, I think I'm gonna go for it. I think I'm just gonna go for it. I'm gonna go for it. I'm gonna go for it. I'm gonna go for it. Oh, I can't. I don't have the balls. I don't have the balls. I'm sorry. I can't. Oof. I don't have the balls. I can't do it. I can't bring myself to do it. There's too many enemies. I can't go anywhere without them raining hell on me. So I just have to do it. I just have to go for it. I'm just gonna have to go for it. Up, up, and away, P. Up, up, and away. When I get up there, the first thing I have to do is dash. And go! Tumble, tumble, tumble! Tumble! Activate the bot, he'll help me out. Alright, as soon as these guys get over here, I need to, like, just pop off on them. And now! Okay, they're all gonna come down here. Are they gonna come down here? I have no idea. If they don't, I can actually use this to my advantage, stand up on this platform, and take them all out. This could be good! Oh, they are fucking gonna regret this shit. They're gonna regret this! Ooh, this is so perfect. I have him cornered. They can't do anything. That is loud, by the way, and I apologize. Not much I can do about that! And that was handled like a boss. Let's just say that was handled like a boss. Natural born Bossaru. NBB. Natural born Bossaru! Hashtag NBB! Get that shit trending! Okay, they're gonna take out my drone. I have to start doing something. I'm gonna activate. Actually, I should have activated that while I had those massive line of enemies there. That would have helped. They're doing a lot of damage to me. I gotta take this safe. Okay, took those guys out. Dealt with that. I can't save him here. I could let him keep attacking them, but I gotta get up there and actually do something here. Oh, the damage. Okay. Let's let the infection deal with him for now. Okay, took him out. Alright, we're gonna jump up here and dash over. Jump! This is not good. There's so many of them. I can't. Okay, here's what I gotta do. I gotta keep dashing and using my full metal jacket. And Bossaru! Okay, I'm gonna dash to the other side. No, dash! Come on, P, you got this! Don't let anybody tell you can't do something! You of all people should know that! Finish off the giant stone golem! Infection, bro. Can we get times two? We got times two. I don't know what that does. I don't know if that increases the damage of it or what. Now I have to deal with these dudes. Which is gonna be a pain in the ass. I could keep doing that, but that's just gonna take a long time. I say we get up there and boss it out. Okay, here's what we're gonna do. Okay! We died! Oh, it's just Brodo! This was not the run. Clearly. This was not the run. Let me know what you guys think of this series, though. Do you guys like this series? I like this series. I think I'm gonna do some Binding of Isaac next. And some FTL. And some Spelunky. And then some other stuff. And if you guys have any suggestions for games that will work with this series, the permadeath kind of games, let me know. I'm gonna avoid games like Minecraft Hardcore and Terraria Hardcore, just because that's kind of like cheese, but, and that could like last forever, but yeah, I want to know what you guys think of this series. If you enjoyed it, be sure to leave a thumbs up and leave a comment letting me know what you like about the series and what your favorite part of this episode was and what your least favorite part of the episode was and when the part where you would say, P-Bad, I hate when you got killed by the Lemurian, and then you say, P-Bad, you classic man, you got a new record on gold.